Hi everyone, Ian Van Tuyl here, and behind me is a new listing of mine in San Diego. This particular vessel is a 2019 Jeanneau 419 Sun Odyssey. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this particular vessel has to offer.
All right, so here we are looking at the Jeanneau 419 Sun Odyssey. The 419 Sun Odyowsey has the bowsprit here. You can see the inner tie rod connected to the bow, giving you that extra structural support, attachment points for asymmetrical code zero. We have the Facnor furling system, LED navigation lights, and again, really beautiful vessel. The Sun Odyssey possesses a low profile cabin top, which gives you this nice sleek look to it as well too. We have composite wood side rails here as well too, so zero maintenance on that. Inboard shrouds, we have side hull ports, and then again, this beautiful long window, just bringing lots of natural light into the salon. As we walk back, you're gonna notice the hard shine that creates from midship and carries back aft, so you get that great volume and stability that gives you in this whole design. The 419 Sun Odyssey also has a large swim platform here that extends the entire transom, which I'll show you a little bit more when we get inside the cockpit. We have a nice bimini that's extended aft as well too, that's a reinforced connector, and then we go into our dodger. The dodger itself has really nice features built into that, which is the integrated side handle, the top handle. This is a really beautiful canvas, thick canvas material, almost as like a coconut husk. And then we have a macro lawn glass here. So very, very sturdy, and it looks like you're looking through a glass windshield. The center portion has a zip out as well that will actually fold back, and that way you get also great ventilation. Large Harkin Traveler, and we also have the main sheet system that leads off to both starboard and port helm. So they call that the German sheeting system. Nice boom vane here. And then again, as our mainsail furls into the mast itself, we have double spreaders. We also have radar, TV antenna, wind points, wind speed, and wind direction at the very top of the mast. Inboard shrouds allows us to walk up to the foredeck easily, and these upper Genoa sheet guides here up on the cabin top, so that allows you to kind of sheet in really tight and point really high into the wind. All flush hatches as well too, and then as we move up forward to the anchor locker, you can see this opens up, and then we have our quick windlass. There's also a remote control here, and then again, that leads right into the bow roller system. So just a nice clean overall approach to the vessel. Clean decks, as I mentioned, as well. We just had all of the wood re-sealed, so that's all been taken care of, and this boat's in really good condition. So we move our way back to the cockpit. You're gonna see for a 41-foot vessel, this is a large cockpit here, large bench seats here. We have our cockpit table that's centrally located. And then moving back, we have obviously the swim platform down. We have a dedicated life raft locker here, swim step shower in this massive swim platform with folding steps that kind of drop out and fold down. So there's a four steps there. This is a manual system that can be used manual or electric. So I find that to be quite nice. And then we have, again, as I talked about, underneath this bench seat, we have propane storage, so double tanks here. We have additional storage here. And then we have our nice little folding out. This is what I really like. This folds up, and then all of our sheets and halyards stow in there quite nicely. Here is the rocker switch to the electric transom as well. Since we're here at the port helm, we have the Raymarine multi-repeater here, so you can toggle through wind, depth, speed, electric two-speed Harkin winch, and that is activating the Genoa sheet, main sheet, and our Genoa furler. So that's what operates that. Centrally located, our Raymarine Axiom GPS radar plotter. We have 12-volt outlets, little glove box here, really nice large opening center storage, and then a forward glove box as well too. The wood leaves fold out on both sides, and they have this really nice stainless steel handrail and footrest too. Over at the starboard helm, We have our throttle controls here. As I power that up to get the current engine hours, we have the multi-repeater, our Raymarine autopilot, our windlass chain counter. You can see we have 347 engine hours on the vessel itself, so very, very light use. And then two-speed Harkin electric winches, bow thruster controls, Jeanneau sheet, main sheet are operated from this electric winch. As we move up, we have large storage off to the starboard side, off to the port side. This actually opens up into the storage room that's accessed also through the shower head compartment. So that's a nice storage area. Electric cabin top winch off to the port side, manual winch off to the starboard side. This is new for the 419, these opening doors. So this opens up and gives you great access into the salon. As we come down below, you can see again, for a 41-foot vessel, this possesses a lot of space, a lot of volume, some beautiful natural light. The galley is off to the starboard side. We start out with a two-burner stove top, oven, broiler, microwave. We have a bottom-loading refrigerator, top-loading access to the refrigerator as well, too, with a small freezer compartment there. Large storage compartments everywhere, double stainless steel sinks, large opening door here with a built-in trash bin, and then again shelving throughout. But they do a nice job on all the solid wood trim throughout the galley itself. This is your propane solenoid on-off switch, and that shuts it off from the back of the boat. So we're here, let's just go aft to the aft cabin. Coming into the aft cabin, this is a large, I want to say almost king size bed, but it's modified a little bit because of the engine access through here. But you do have an opening hatch here, a side hull port there, another side window and overhead opening hatch. This is on a screen and shade as well too. And then you have drop down shades for the rest of them. But yeah, really nice large aft cabin space here. We do have our hanging locker closet and then shelving throughout this as well too. So again, that's really nicely accessed here, so you can just see how much storage you actually get here. All right, moving back through the galley, looking directly across from the galley, we have access to our day head and our nav station, and then our companionway steps. This is a nice gradual step entry here. This opens up, so this gets us access to the Yanmar engine, and you can see that 315-22, the water pump impeller was done, and then 12-9-23 at 304 hours, the engine was serviced as well too. So yeah, really nicely done. Very, very beautiful and very well taken care of. Let's go to the head compartment. What I love about this is it has a separate shower from the sink area. So you have storage, stainless steel sink, nice fixture here, a nice mirror, opening hatch, overhead opening hatch, and then your shower compartment with this divider that closes off. And then your manual toilet here, access to the holding tank. This is a little towel rack. And this is that door that I was telling you that goes into our large storage area. So opening access above, but just tons of space, you know, to put that inflatable dinghy, the electric outboard, kayaks, paddles, and just whatever you want. All right, coming back into the salon, I'm gonna take you to the nav station. Here we have, this is called like their pillow top cushion. So this is a fabric. It's like an off-white fabric, like linen color, really beautiful. Fusion stereo. We have a USB plug here, our Raymarine VHF. This is our tank indication gauge. So this will monitor our fuel, our double water tanks, and our house and start battery. 12 volt, 110. As I mentioned, we have the Raymarine VHF. We also have the smart controller pilot. So you can, this is a remote control for your autopilot. It'll also give you depth, speed, and everything else that you could want. Forward facing nav station. So, you know, obviously great use of space here, and then goes into our massive salon. This is all one level on the flooring as well too. This is the light oak floor with the teak wood interior. The salon table can remove to put smaller legs and drop that down into a bed if so desired. I don't believe there's cushions for this, but I could be mistaken. Large U-shaped seating around a salon table. Large bench seat here off to the port side. Again, lots of cabinets, storage throughout. There are closing blinds here, and there are blinds here that drop down and close this off for privacy as well too. Overhead, we have two opening hatches. We have built-in grab handles here, LED lighting throughout. Our compression post is hidden by this wood cabinet, so you're not seeing a metal pole right here in the middle of your classy salon. So I like that addition as well too. And as I mentioned, you know, very flat floor all the way through. Coming to the V berth and second head compartment. The V berth itself, very standard V berth here. We have shelving on each side, aviation shades on the side ports. We have this overhead opening hatch, and I love that it also has an angle as well too, so you can actually see forward when you are standing here. We have hanging shelving, additional storage below here, so lots of storage throughout the vessel. I have these really cool LED lights that just kind of offset it, 110 12 volt outlet as well too, and reading lamps at both sides of the head. Here at the head compartment itself, we have electric Jabsco Quiet Flush toilet. We have the stainless steel sink. This is also the sink faucet is used as your shower. So when the door is closed, that's where this kind of goes into, and then your shower sump. So I get the question a lot, like, oh, what about the wood? So this wood has been tested by Jeanneau, actually sat there in salt water absorbent. This is all waterproof. My only suggestion is it is good to just wipe it down after use, but otherwise it is waterproof and it is solid. So nice shower head compartment here. And then looking back aft, this will give us a nice perspective of the vessel facing aft. All right, well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to this 2019 Jeanneau 419 Sun Odyssey, please feel free to give me a call at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business and getting you, your family, and friends out on the water. Thank you again, and bye for now.